In the previous video, we discussed crawlability. And we looked at all the ways that you can make sure that certain parts of your site are not accessible to search engines. All of this can be a bit tedious if you don't have a technical background. That's why we take care of a lot of aspects of crawlability for you in our Yoast SEO plugin. In this video, we'll explore what the plugin does. You'll learn what options you have to make sure that Google can index everything you want to show in the search results. And of course, that search engines stay away from everything you don't want to show in the search results. Let's start with the basic settings. In the search appearance settings, you can determine your default settings for every type of content available in WordPress. For every type of content, we ask you whether you want search engines to put it into the search results. If you pick no, we add a no index robots meta tag, making sure that nothing will show up on the results page. You can do this for posts, pages, tags, and lots of other kinds of content. Just choose yes or no to either show or not show them in the search results. And don't worry if you're not sure about what you should choose. If you don't do anything, the settings reflect what is best in most cases. If your theme or developer has created other content types, you can see them there as well. Now, say that you have told the search engines to actually put all posts in the search results with the search appearance settings. But say that you now have a post which you don't want to appear in Google. For example, because it's an old article that you're not very proud of. Can you also no index specific posts? Well, yes, of course you can. To do this, go to the Advanced tab of the Yoast SEO meta box beneath your post. Here you have the same option we discussed earlier, only now this applies to only that specific post. The only difference is that here you have a third option, which is to always follow the default setting you set earlier. Besides determining whether the post should be shown in the results, you can also choose whether to allow search engines to follow links on the page. If your SEO skills are a little more advanced, you can also tell Google not to put images from the post into the index, to not archive the post, which means Google cannot show a previously saved copy of the page, or to not show a snippet in the search results. We advise you to stay away from this unless you really know what you're doing. But it's good to know it's there for you to use if you need it. And you can not only change your settings for posts, but also for pages and tags and so on and so forth. If you want to move beyond the simple crawlability settings, the Yoast SEO plugin also allows you to easily edit your own robots.txt file. We already discussed robots.txt in the previous video. It's a file in which you tell the search engine which URLs on that site it's allowed to visit. And how this works is advanced stuff, which is beyond the scope of this course. You can learn more about how to edit your robots.txt in our technical SEO course. Okay, so now you know how you can determine your crawlability settings for a content category and for individual posts or pages, etc., and where to edit your robots.txt. But is it possible to quickly check your indexability? Yes, it is. There are actually several ways to do this. Let's start with the easiest one. If you go to your WordPress dashboard, you'll see the Yoast SEO posts overview. There, below the published SEO scores, you'll see a tool called the indexability check by right. This tool gives you feedback on whether your homepage is indexable. If it's not, you need to fix this immediately. If it is, you know for sure that the search engines are at least able to index part of your site. The last plugin feature that is important when it comes to crawlability is the Search Console setting. Here you can connect with Google Search Console and check all the crawl errors that Google encountered when crawling your site. This is a great way to check what individual pages have crawlability issues. There are two basic errors Google can encounter. First of all, there may be site-wide problems, like connectivity issues or problems fetching your robots.txt file. More often, though, there are problems with individual URLs. The page may have been deleted, for example. And solving these errors, generally by making redirects, makes it much easier for Google to crawl your site, which can have a positive effect on your rankings. So, good luck.
Hey, great job learning more about the Yoast SEO plugin. But honestly, just watching videos on YouTube isn't enough to make you a good SEO. So why not get the full SEO for Beginners training experience? It's completely free. This video is just a start. The actual training has additional reading materials, quizzes, and other tools that help you to actually practice your new skills. When you complete the training, you'll also receive an official Yoast certificate of completion and a discount for our other training courses. Check out the full course in the description below.